Hi, thank you for watching a new video blog. People ask me, well, Jonathan, what is the school system that you prefer? What kind of school would you send your children to? And what do you think about all these different school systems that are around? Well, first of all, let me say, when I hear parents discuss how great their school is, how their school is one of the best for their children. And to me it's just hilarious, because they're like, oh, we have this class and they can do this and so much more attention for this side of the child, and they do this and they have like an hour of extra work time for blah blah blah, they do art. And to me it's just really, like I say, hilarious and just laughable to think that a school system is any good at all. And you can have a school where, wow, they do just like 2% less damaging things to your child than on the other school, but eventually it also comes down to just the school system in itself is of course really anti-nature, and it's damaging to your children. And I've seen this myself. I noticed that I'm from a big family where we were with 8 children at home. And I saw that my sweet little sister was doing fine at home, was like the sweetest. And when she went to school, every time she went the longer she stayed in the school, I saw her changing. I now see that this also happened to me. I was a child like anybody else. I loved to be at home with my mom was a stay-at-home mom, and I really liked it. And then I had to go to kindergarten. First it was nice. I went to first like a pre-kindergarten, and they would do like fun things like sing and do nice things that were okay. I enjoyed it, but then I slowly went to kindergarten, and then it all started to fall apart for me. It just was like a system. There were chores and tasks and expectations, and you can do this, you can have to do that. It was really like a prison in my mind. It was not fun at all. I thought that the teachers were really grumpy and annoyed and irritated, and the children also didn't seem to like it. They were bored, they wanted to play and they cannot play, they had to sit down. So it's just, how can you even think that the school system is any good? School system is anti-nature, because the child wants to play. It wants to play, it wants to learn, it wants to learn things that are useful. So I prefer my kids to be homeschooled, but of course you have to you need to have a partner that will agree on this. But for me, I really don't care about the school at all. So when they go to school, I don't really care about how good they do or how such a brave child they will be in school, how quiet they were, how noble they were by listening to the boring stories of the teacher, or the boring course that they had to do. I would be sad to see that they do all these things. My children have to go through all these super boring things that you will never ever need. And besides, my vision is that we should avoid civilization, and a school is preparing you for civilization. It will do anything to make you become somebody that is useful in civilization. But I don't believe in civilization, I believe in nature, so I want to teach my children things that you can use in nature. For example, providing for yourself, being self-sustaining, self-sufficient. How do I clean water? How do I keep chicken and rabbits and other animals that you can breed and live off? And how can I find food for the chicken in nature? Where can I fish? How can I prepare the fish? How can I store a fish? How can I store meat for longer? Can I dry it? How do I build a house? How do I take care of my children? You know, all these things, it's more important than what you learn in school. You learn the most weird and boring things in school. And of course, children will bully each other because you get put together with total strangers that you don't like, that you don't know, that are totally not like you. And you get friends with the people that are most close to you. And this is, of course, this comes from nature, where you just find the people that you love, that you like family, people that are like your family. And in school, it's just like put together in a room, which is total unnatural. Children needs to be outside, needs to play outside, needs to touch nature, you know, like feel the grass, want to find some sticks to play with, find animals, discover things, learn things, and just be outside. And you don't even have to teach your children that much, because they will find things by themselves. So yeah, I think that it doesn't matter if you go to Waldorf school or to a liberal school or to a Catholic school or to whatever kind of school, that it's any good. So just hilarious, you know, the people say, oh my, I learned so much in my Catholic school. First of all these things are the schools, they teach the same things. Second of all, it just comes down the area that you live in. I worked in a school, I worked in high schools, different high schools, and if you're in a bad neighborhood, you just get bad education, you get just a negative atmosphere. If you're in a wealthy environment, you get a little bit better atmosphere, because the children will obey you more, because they know, when I don't do it, I will not go to Saint-Tropez this year, or I will not get my motorcycle, or blah blah blah, you know. They just get they will just blackmail children by obeying the school system. And of course, children in a bad neighborhood, they understand that they will understand it better than the teachers, that their graduation that they make is just worthless. It doesn't mean anything. It's just like garbage. And if you come from a good area, of course, you know that you can get in easier, because it's just like a one gathering of people that know each other. So you just have to get the paper in, but you're in, you're already in. Your father has influential friends, so you don't have to worry that much. You just have to follow everything and you'll just be fine. When they say, oh yeah, my school has this or that, and they pay attention to art, well, you know, art, when I was in school and they did art, it was always like super boring, you know. It was never something in this, for example, when I wanted to draw something, I always had to draw something else. I just wanted to draw like a scenery, and oh no, I have to draw something like with colors, something abstract. And when I wanted to do something abstract, no, I had to do something with third dimension in it. And it was just like a course. It wasn't really like something that was playing into your emotional fields. Yeah, no, school system to me, it's just like weird when people ask me this, and I laugh when I see them discussing, oh, I have this, oh, they're so nice, they do this in my school, and oh, look, the marks are so good in this school. And if a school has good marks, it's just like faked. It's all just one big fake. They will fake good marks, they remove bad students, children from the school way before they have to do their exams. So what you get is like, it's like, you know, after 5 years you have the people that will be able to get the silly tests, and people that are not smart enough, they have already been left. So of course they will say, look, our school is so great, they all get like straight marks and they're like the best. Yeah, sure. No, my preferred school system, if you want to call it that way, is natural teaching, natural homeschooling, focused on nature, natural homeschooling. That would be my choice. So no school system for me. I got this question many times, and well, you know my answer by now. So it was for today. Thank you for watching. See you next time.